And now I'm going to guide you in some, in a series of spontaneous release techniques, which I found over the years very, very useful for the shoulder, and I strongly recommend them to you. Now, what you do is you put your thumb along the shoulder joint and you find areas which you could call trigger areas or trigger points, which are quite painful. Of course, don't press hard on a ligament or tendon because it's going to hurt anyhow. So just find the genuine trigger point. Now, when you find it, hold on the area, take the elbow, and move by, you keep your thumb on the trigger point, and you move the elbow, creating a lever with the humerus here, which gives a sense of relief. Either you can feel it yourself under your thumbs, or the receiver can give you feedback, and you find a sense of relief to the trigger point. Once you have found that, you create a gentle rotation, freeing the area and keeping that lever point. Okay, then you can hold it like this, not moving, and you can hold it between 30 to 90 seconds as required. Okay, and in this way you can find different trigger points, finding different levers from the elbow and humor, and releasing them. Now, let's say if you don't want to work specifically on trigger points, you can always use this movement just to create a sense of release throughout the shoulder joint. Okay? You can go here, you can go here. And you hold your fingers and thumb on the shoulder itself, and you create different lever points using the elbow as the navigation. Nice way to release the shoulder joint. Okay, and again we finish creating a little rocking and gentle rubbing and squeezing, mainly squeezing here and pulling. Now, a movement you can do to help the scapula, which is very much connected to the shoulder, when the person is on their back, is just put your fingers beneath the scapula, just on the border closest to the spine, and gently, I'm pushing with my hand in this way, and creating a gentle traction with my arm as well. As I said previously, when you treat the shoulder, you have to treat the receiver also when they're with their stomach down, so you can massage the trapezius and the scapula and thoracic areas, which are connected to the shoulder. And I've shown plenty of clips to that effect. And you can even do, from shiatsu and oriental massage, lying on the side techniques, with the receiver lying on their side. You can do numerous things to free the shoulder. Now, a lovely technique, your hand beneath the shoulder, and move towards you with the hand and slightly rotate their forearm. Okay, and again, let's do gentle pulling and rocking. And now, gently, with your hands in this position, let's rotate it a little bit. First to one side, and then to the other. Squeeze.